so much for clicking on this video and joining me here. You might think I look a little bit different because I'm completely empty neck today, because we are talking necklace again today, as you saw from the thumbnail. And we are talking about the Cartier D'amour necklace, and I have a stacking video and I think an unboxing video also on my channel, and you can go check it out on the XS, the extra small size. And I do love the extra small size, and we are looking today at the extra small Cartier D'amour necklace, and in the XS, the extra small size, and the large size. I got the large size as a gift, and I couldn't say no, and I also didn't want to exchange it or anything like that, but we will look into both necklace sizes. They both have a huge price difference. The XS size is, when I bought it, it was $890 USD. It was well under $1,000, so that was a very good price. And when I bought it, the large diamond was $2,250. That was before the price increase. And I meant the time when I bought the XS size, the large diamond was $2,250. So the price difference, $2,250 minus $900, you can do the math, and was significant price difference. And I did not consider buying the large diamond after having the XS size. The XS size was working very well for me, wearing it alone, stacking it. I will put some stacking footage here. And I love the XS size, and I will tell you at the end what I think, if the large diamond is worth buying or not buying, and we will look at them closely so you can see what's different between them, and I will also give you mod shots. So you guys, this is the large Cartier diamond, and they are both in yellow gold. So this is the large size of the Cartier D'amour diamond. This is how it looks, and now I show you the small size. Here a few more close-ups so you can see it very well. The chain is diamond cut, very sparkly, beautiful. So here is the extra small size, and the sizes available in the Cartier diamond necklace are extra small, small, and the large one. I have also a comparison between the extra small and the small, and I will show you that here, how the extra small and the small look compared with each other. So, but this is how the extra small looks on its own, and I think you can wear it on its own. But usually what I do with this one is stacking it. I did stack both of them, but I feel usually more comfortable stacking the extra small one. The large one, I personally would wear on its own, because I feel when you stack the large one, it becomes a little bit overpowering. So this is the Cartier Clash necklace, and I'm pairing it here with the small diamond. And I'll show you also how it looks with the large diamond. And I have a full video on how I stack the small diamond on my channel. I will link it below in the description box if you want to look a little bit more how it looks. I do love the Cartier diamond a lot. So this is how it looks with the large diamond, and it doesn't look bad, but I feel when you wear the large diamond with another pendant, it takes away from the other pendant, while the small, the extra small one supports the other pendant. So I would wear this rather alone, and this stacked with, or any other pendant stacked with the XS size. So you guys, here we are to look a little bit closer and compare the two of the diamond chains. This is the visual. And I will also add the details, the exact length and diamond carat and everything, as a screenshot most likely in this video or in the description box. But this is the visual of the XS size and the large size of the Cartier D'amour diamond necklace. And they are both in, mine are both in yellow gold. They come also in rose gold and white gold. And they both have, both versions have the diamond cut chain. The chain comparison visually is like this. I personally, of course, the XS diamond has a thinner chain than the large diamond, but like I said, both are diamond cut, and it's not that they saved any detail on the XS one. And like I said, the XS one was under under 1k, and the large one was over 2k. And this is how it looks. This is the large one, this is the extra small one. The chain is more dainty than the large one, but I feel it has still the same sturdiness and quality like the large one. Another difference between the two of them is the pendant in the back. This is the Cartier logo pendant. You can buy a necklace with the Cartier logo pendant by itself. I think it's also around 2k. And here with this diamond necklace, you can get the pendant kind of as a bonus. And if you feel you want to show the pendant, you can wear, which I never did, but you could wear the necklace upside down, like turn it around, like put the diamond in the back and the pendant in the front. And you didn't have to buy the Cartier pendant necklace anymore. I'll insert a picture of which one I'm talking about here. The large diamond has a larger pendant. The small diamond, of course, has a smaller pendant, but it is still visible, and I love that they added this at the backside of the necklace, because I wear my hair up most of the time, and it looks very pretty when this hangs down your neck in the back. So it looks beautiful from the backside and the front side. This is the size difference visually. And the length of the necklace is exactly the same, and like I said, you will either see a screenshot in the video or see it in the description box. The frame is not taking it, but you have to take my word. The length of the necklace and everything is exactly the same of the XS one and the large one. And I'll take you up a little now. Here are a few close-ups how this looks with the large pendant. Yeah, you guys, is the extra small by itself. So you guys, here is the last visual. I'm showing you the XS and the large one stacked with each other, and I will give you my verdict what you should buy and if you need both in a minute. But this is the visual of the XS size and the large size. So you guys, so my final verdict between these two necklaces is to buy the XS necklace. The XS necklace is still well under 1k, the large one is well over 2k, and I think the XS does the job. I use it more than the large one. You can stack it, you can wear it by yourself, but of course now that I have the large one, when I decide to wear a diamond by itself, I choose the large one. But when I had only this one, I wore this also a lot by itself, and I would choose, because of the price, the XS Cartier D'amour necklace over the large one. As a little note to the side, there is also the small necklace. The small necklace, I don't have the small necklace, but the small necklace has a thicker chain than the XS, and the XS diamond carat weight totals in 0.04, which is very tiny, and the small one totals in 0.09, and I believe the small, this one is 910 right now, I think. This one is 2220 right now, I think, but I will insert the screenshots. And the small one is 1319, I think. So the small one is price wise and appearance wise right between these two. So as a little side note, go and look at the small one as well. I have footage here of the small one comparing to the XS, and I most likely, if I would stand in front of the decision again, would purchase the small one. And if I want to save 400 more from the small one, you can be rest assured you will be happy with the XS size as well. So I hope you found this video helpful and it helped you or supported your decision in your purchase regarding the diamond necklace. Of course, you always have the option, if you don't need Cartier or a luxury brand, to go to your personal jeweler or a small jewelry store and pick out your own diamond and chain and have it custom made, which is also a fantastic option, I think, and go from there. So I hope again this was helpful, and I see you in the next one. Bye.